Welcome back. We're about to go take a rest. I mean, we just took down a dragon. We stopped a war. We've done a lot today. We need to take a break. So we're heading back to our old, or at least Rose's old hideout for her scattered bones.
Asleep or awake.
It's kind of creepy you guys are just watching me like that.
No need to worry. Saray's got it together.
Yes, I know. But...
He's almost two together, huh? Sounds like something a mother would say.
Can it be sister at least? Although I am far older.
All right, sister. We ought to rest up too.
Yes. I'll just tuck both of them in.
Alright, we're all nice and rest up. That's good. Thanks for sleeping in there, Rose. We're waiting for you.
Not even. You've been sleeping for 3 days straight.
You're kidding! I was wondering why I was so famished.
Let's go get something to eat.
Indeed, Saray woke up just before you did.
After we're done, let's head on over to Lastenbell. I gotta check on how everything wound up.
Sheesh, workaholic much? Though I guess I shouldn't talk.
Aren't you curious?
Well... Yeah. If anyone's warmongering, I got some killing to do.
Maybe we should leave her here.
What? No, we're not leaving her. Good, she's coming with us. Okay, so we're heading over to Lastenbell, is what, or what's going on here? There we go, just over there, eh? I wonder if it's gonna let me save travel. It hasn't been letting me save travel at all the past, few little times. Oops. Nope. Alright, looks like we're almost there. It was a short walk, so it wasn't too bad. Again, there's nothing here, so I'm wondering what's gonna happen. Oh,
look.
Here we go.
Elysia and Lucas!
So, what's going on here, people? You guys were all buddy-buddy before.
The Kingdom of Highland, I
and
am
now
here to
they're
discuss terms
still kind
of,
truce. Of...
I would like to meet with a representative of the Roland's Imperial Army.
We honestly wish we could allow you to pass, but Highland and Roland's are still officially at war.
This is a decision that has to be made at the top. I'm afraid as mere rank and file, we...
Elysia! Lucas!
Saray!
I knew you were alive!
You're meeting with Roland's?
I hope. It seemed like this might be the last chance for diplomacy.
A Highland princess wandering all the way here with no escort? You're a trooper.
What do you mean? She's got the best guard in the world.
If there's a chance we can stop the war, it's a small price to pay. But we're running into some, jurisdictional issues.
Shepard?
You're with the Platinum Knights, right? Do you think you could contact Sergei for us? Tell him that Saray's friend, Elysia, has come to visit.
If it's a meeting between friends, then the Knights have no need to interfere.
No, he's right there.
I'm sorry my subordinates couldn't be more flexible with you.
Not their fault. I hear they work under a very rigid captain.
You caught me there. So you're Elysia. I am Sergei, a friend of Saray. Well met.
I'm Elysia. My sincere thanks for helping us the other day.
Not at all. Would you like to join me for some tea?
Certainly. I'm thankful for this opportunity.
We won't let it go to waste.
Damn peaceniks. Putting good mercenaries out of jobs. This calls for booze. What do you say, Shepard?
Oh, guards, left their post, I guess. Where were we going? Go to the sanctuary. Where is the sanctuary? It is... right there. I think this is where we first met Sergei. Oh, good times, good times. Let's see here. Why would they meet inside here? Peace and quiet, maybe?
All right, that should do it for now.
Yes, thank you for all your help.
Aw, it's over already?
The first meet and greet, I've received an invitation to Pendrago Castle.
By yourself?
In exchange, His Imperial Majesty of Rolands will allow me to meet for direct negotiations. Not bad for a bottom-rung princess, huh?
We are comrades who battled the dragon together. The Empire will have the decency to acknowledge that.
Neat.
Guess the peace talks are in good hands.
And here I thought the war would be dragon on and on.
Oh no, that was a pretty good one! I'm jealous.
Is it a competition?
Saray, would you be interested in coming to Pendrago with us? You're a key figure in bringing our two nations together.
Thanks. But that's a dream that you should be the one to fulfill.
I suppose. Best to you on your journey.
You too, Elysia. Sergei.
Not to mention our plastered buddy out there.
Okay, so, we saved the world, right? Nothing left to do there. Game's over. Everyone's all nice and happy. We might as well, do this. Alright, yeah, so we still have the Lord of Calamity that we haven't, we've kind of been ignoring him for the past little while. I'm not sure what our plan is with him. It seems his plan...
That Princess Elysia is a godsend.
That's good.
She sure
People
is.
Like her.
If only a certain layabout would follow her example.
My doggie's happy too. She hates war.
You and me both, puppy. You and me both. Hey, bud. You up for a drink?
Anything to get out of this armor.
Our departure can wait a day.
Huh? But...
So sleepy all of a sudden.
Oh, my back. I gotta lie down.
Get us a nice room.
Come on.
I guess it's time to party. Alright. So yeah, the Lord of Calamity's plan to get a war started didn't really work out. It kinda actually backfired, didn't it?
Thanks, Lila, for hanging out with me.
How'd you guys get up there?
Don't mention it. I was thinking of coming up here and watching the city anyway.
So this is where Saray's guidance has led us.
Indeed. I'm sure he is doing much the same, watching them and thinking about how far we've come. Edna and Zavid, too. After our long journey with the Shepherd, I imagine they're using this time to reflect on their past, and perhaps their future.
Kinda like us, huh?
Well, well. Edna coming to see me? Should I be scanning the skies for pigs?
I want you to tell me, why were you killing Hellions?
Where'd this come from? And why now?
Is it to save them? Did you make up your mind that it's something you have to do in order to save them, like Saray did?
Oh, I get it. You still haven't quite wrapped your head around the idea of death as a form of salvation. And so every time you put it into words, it's been to convince yourself.
Is a smart woman. I imagine right now she's busy sorting out her feelings before we face our final battle.
Okay, so they haven't forgot about
no
it
doubt
at least.
She's consulting Zavid for guidance, He's seen more of the world than any of us, the good and the bad.
You're really a good study of people. You should have been a school teacher.
Oh, but Rose, you had something you wanted to ask me, didn't you?
When the dragon appeared, Saray found his answer right then and there, didn't he? It was that he didn't want that battlefield to see any further killing or bloodshed.
Yes. And then he immediately took the actions he deemed necessary in order to achieve that. Time flows differently for people with a vision, or so it seems to the rest of us sometimes.
He's incredible.
Wow, look at all those stars. Yeah. I forget who said it, that there are as many emotions as stars in the sky. I can totally see that.
A metaphor for how each emotion sparkles in its own way, huh? Must have been a romantic who came up with that one.
But you can also sense his insecurities about that, can't you, Rose? Like he's constantly on edge, worrying that if he let his guard down even a little bit, he'd lose his way again.
I think Saray himself might be the only one who doesn't see that. I mean, you know how little it takes for a taut string to go snap, right?
Are you worried?
Not worried, really. Whatever happens, whatever the future brings, I hope I can make it work somehow. No, I know I can.
So that's your answer.
I guess so. But I've always been like this, ever since I was a kid.
I'm starting to understand why you don't generate any malevolence.
So I want everyone not to worry, and to just go do what they need to do. Pow! But I don't mean like, see ya, have fun, I'll be over here. I promise I'm with the rest of you guys for the long haul.
Don't you think it would be better to tell that to everyone, not just me? After all, I'm sure Edna and Zavid would take no small amount of inspiration from it.
Huh, I don't know. It'd be weird to walk up to them and be like, I am here! We are friends!
Probably true.
Sheesh, you women folks sure are complicated. But then, that's part of the appeal.
Are you just stupid?
Yep, big old stupid head. The type who can't do anything but believe in the one way he's found to get stuff done.
What makes you believe in it?
I just have a need to protect the pride of my friends and fellow Seraphim. No one becomes a Hellion because they want to. But when you turn into one, you know what that means, right? So that's why I end it for them. For the sake of their pride.
And you think that saves them?
Who knows? That's something they get to ponder after death, in their own personal afterlife.
How gallant of you. So that must be what makes you so...
attractive? Ow! Hey! Knock it off! Don't you all have one more thing you need to brace yourselves for?
It'll depend on what Saray does with Maltellus after we take down Heldolf. But you know what? That's all right. I'm prepared. No matter what he decides, I'm willing to accept it.
Gotta say, I think your resolve wins out over mine. I don't even know if I could do that. Just look on silently while one of our own suffers in agony.
Well, I wouldn't worry too much about that. We're all in this together till the very end.
So, if Zavid's quivering in fear, you'll be there to give him a gentle hug, right?
Gross.
Well, if my saying something is enough to cheer those two up, it might be worth it after all.
It's enough to have someone to lend you a kind word. After all, that's what friends and comrades are for. But Rose, if you don't mind, may I ask what prompted you to bring all this up?
I just kind of thought you and I might have sort of been thinking about stuff along the same lines. I just wanted to tell you, you don't have to carry it all by yourself. Huh? What? Did I say something funny?
Huh? The two of us really are more alike than we realize. We commit to things. We decide on what role we're gonna play without really consulting with anyone else.
Oh, now that you mention it. So that's why I felt like we might be sharing the same thoughts. We're the same, independent women.
Rose, I must thank you. I feel like a great load has been taken off my mind.
Really? Hey, cool beans!
I'm profoundly grateful to whatever twist of fate brought us together.
You really are a drama queen, Lila.
Aw, Rose!
All right, come on. We got some friends to go cheer up.
There's something I learned from this journey. Some stars you can't see, and because you can't see them, you think they're not shining. They are.
It turned out that there were a lot of stars that we couldn't see from our home in Elysia.
Once people notice the stars, they start to understand just how brilliantly they shine. Just like how Elysia finally got a sense of what Seraphim were truly like the first time she heard your voices.
That was a trip. You should have seen your face.
I was really excited back then. It gave me hope that one day other humans might be able to talk to the Seraphim.
But even then, you had to cut off your senses and hold your... Oh, I see. You were actually contemplating what you'll do after the last battle.
Yeah. If I let myself become a vessel for Mautelus and shut off all my senses, we might be able to spread that power throughout the entire continent of Glenwood. If it works, and that's a big if, the Squire ought to be able to wield power like mine, even if she doesn't possess natural ability on par with a shepherd.
So long as you entrusted all of your senses to the Squire, it's not out of the question. And we might be able to grow the ranks of squires who could help us. Just think of Elysia. It's arguably a more constructive approach than just waiting for another shepherd to appear.
Exactly.
But you understand the implications, don't you?
Yeah. Until the squires can quell enough of the Earth's malevolence to let Mautelus' natural purification take over, I would need to wait and sleep.
By bonding with Mautelus, you'll be abandoned in time. It could take years. It could take centuries. And even if humans appear who can see and talk to Seraphim, there's no guarantee they'll choose the path of coexistence.
I believe in them.
What about your dream? Weren't you going to go off exploring ruins around the world?
My dream will live on, so long as I don't forget.
Very well. Thank you, Mikleo.
Stupid.
It's not so much that guys are stupid. It's just that the ladies are too smart.
What's that? Your philosophy?
Huh. Looks like the gang's all here. I suppose you were all listening to us then?
Yes.
I may not be Edna, but you really are...
Totally...
stupid.
Let's head out.
Huh? We're not waiting till morning?
No farewells to Elysia or anyone?
I'd like to set out under these stars tonight. So that every time I gaze up at the night sky, I can remember this very day.
Guess we've got our own romantic right here.
You think so?
So what's up? Are we going?
Yeah.
To the last battle.
Yeah.
All right then. No doubts, no regrets.
Let's go.
All right, so that was, wow, that was something else. I guess we really are near the end then. Gonna go ahead and save that. I guess it did already for us. Head to Elysia, in search of Camlin. Here we go. And of course, can we get here? We can, okay. Where else can we go? No. Entrance abandoned, blah. Sure. I think this is somewhat close to where we're going. I'm not sure. This is, yeah, I think we want to go up here. Yes, here we go.
Once we're through the forest, we'll arrive at Saray and Mikleo's hometown, right?
Huh?
Whoa, what's wrong?
Mikleo. Yeah, I don't feel Gramps' blessed domain. Did something happen in Elysia?
You guys, let's hurry!
Yeah.
We have been gone a very long time, and...
so much malevolence, it's stifling.
Let's try fighting something.
First in such a state. Oh, it's an elderly.
How graceful and cute its name is. If you say so.
What? How are they? Let's see here. This is blocked off, is it? Oh, OK. Can we break this? No, apparently. Okay, apparently we can. It just didn't let us before for some reason. And what has that done? Not much. Let's see. Okay, so...
I could use something to eat.
Oh, Lila, stop. You're fine. Okay, we got a life bottle at least, so that's helpful. But we have no peach shells. And only a couple
Someone
life bottles left.
Someone who could wield their powers even within Zenris's domain must have led humans and Hellions into this place.
I wonder who it could be.
Maybe he was trying to get the humans to destroy the seal so he could get to Camlon.
I don't know about that. Remember, he's linked up with Mautellus. He could probably cut through that seal like butter.
Yeah. No doubt Heldolf is already camped out at Camlon, waiting for us. This is likely just his way of tormenting me.
Well then, if we waste any more time here, we're just falling into his trap.
Then let's press on to Elysia.
Pretty obvious what Kittybeard is after.
Yes, corrupting Saray with malevolence, I take it.
Saray's aware of it. You can tell he's trying his best to keep it together, despite the circumstances.
Ugh, screw you, Smeldolf! No one can keep their head on straight when their friends and family are in mortal danger!
Who knows what evils he may be plotting in order to cause Saray further heartache?
I can hazard a few guesses. We gotta stop him, no matter what!
Let's go.
Held off, what a cheap trick. You really think you can, corrupt Saray here? I don't think that's gonna happen. Alright, another life bottle, so that's good. There's something following us and it's fast. It's really fast. Oh, we made it. Okay, good. Uh-oh, what the hell is this? Is there a save point? Yeah, there is. I wonder if we can travel, because I'd like to, we can, eh? I think. Can I go to... No. Where can I go? Okay, well, let's just see if we can beat this without any of our items. My god, this thing is terrifying.
Darn it!
A powerful Hellion like this right at Elysia's gate!
Saray! Yeah! Take this one out!
Okay. Ow. How much health does it have? 29,000, ooh. Spread out, please, for the love of God, spread out. Oh, we almost got it, we almost got it. How much? 7,000 still. Oh no. God damn it. God damn it. Okay, I really need to get some healing potions. This is just... Ugh, but I can't save travel for some stupid reason. Why not? Can I do anything? Why doesn't it let me save travel? I don't understand. Okay, whatever. We're just gonna try to beat it. Stupid. Stupid, there's no reason I shouldn't be able to save travel right now, but whatever.
A powerful
Okay, I get it. Let's go. Yeah, damn. What are you doing, Saray? That's not what I'm telling you to do. I still don't get why I don't do damage sometimes. Ow. Oops. God, this breath attack is so annoying. Okay. And split up for now. I think it does heal. Heal yourself, please. Just keep healing, Mikleo. That does a lot of damage. How much else have we got? We got 9,000. Okay, he's just going crazy now with his attacks. Okay, please get me up. Oh, I can't armatize with her. Thousand health, we can do this. Uh-oh, what's it doing? 3,000. Did it heal? It did heal, didn't it? No, I had it! It was there! The armatization was there! How much health? 2,000 health. Okay, we can do this. There we go. Wow. We actually did pretty good for considering all things. Yeah, we gotta go. Okay. Yeah, I want to save after that. Okay. that was a pretty tough fight. Okay. Oops, that's not what I wanted. Save. Oops, there we go. Alright. Let's see here. We're closing in on this final battle here. Let's see. Lots of dead soldiers.
They must have become Hellions, losing themselves and turning on each other.
How could this happen?
It's possible they simply had the same thought that Heldolf also had back in the day. Elysia and Camlon are strategically valuable, right?
But the war is practically over already!
Which goes to show you how much some morons don't want it to end.
Yeah, but they're not the only ones responsible for this. There's massive amounts of malevolence pouring out from somewhere.
Probably a sign that the seal my mother forged has been broken.
Gramps, everyone, please be safe.
I don't see any of our friends or our family's dead bodies, so that's good. It's just soldiers. There's a thing we can sleep there. We don't need to sleep right now.
Something's wrong.
Yeah.
All these bodies of Highland soldiers, but no sign of the people who live here.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Everyone...
Please, both.
What's happening here? Whoa.
Ow!
It's a barrier.
Huh.
It must be something Zenris set up to prevent humans from breaking in.
Gramps! It's me, Saray!
Saray? Saray, you're back!
Yes, thank goodness!
Saray!
Oh, thank goodness. I'm so glad you're all okay.
Where's Gramps?
He told us to wait here. He said that he was going to go drive out the humans.
He went out alone in all this malevolence?
I'm sorry. We should have been there with him.
But even if we had, we would only have gotten in his way.
We left him out there to die.
Hey, like Lila keeps saying, reflection good, regrets bad.
There's no way Gramps would fall so easily.
Saray.
I'll go find him. Kaim, everybody, stay right here.
If everyone else was safe, Gramps must be too.
Oh god,
here's
it's our
gate of the dawn of chaos that Gramps headed towards.
Favorite little girl.
It's her.
We can no longer tell how you will respond. And so, as you can see, we determined this to be the only remaining option available to us.
You did this? Whatever plots you hatch, it doesn't matter. I already have my answer.
Do you hate me then? Do you wish to plunge that sword into my breast?
Where is Gramps, Simone?
He went to the gate of the Dawn of Chaos to drive away the Earth Dwellers flooding in. Though it's far too late at this point to do anything.
Alright, well, I think we're actually gonna save there. I'm gonna leave this on a bit of a cliffhanger. We're gonna finish this off next time. We're gonna go to the Dawn, or the Gate of the Dawn of Chaos, I guess, which is find a way to Camlon, which is, I don't know where that is, but we'll find it next time, and we'll probably find Gramps. Hopefully he's not dead, and maybe we'll fight the Lord of Calamity. I'm not sure, we'll have to find out. See you then. And goodbye.